I'm Ofelia and I do my PhD at the Institute of Molecular Biology of Barcelona. I work in the topology of the DNA laboratory, and the objective of my thesis is to study the topology of nucleosomal DNA in regulatory regions as the promoters and the centromere. Well, by the end of the talk, I would like that you were able to answer these two questions. What is a nucleosome and what is the main difference between a canonical nucleosome and the centromeric nucleosome? But we will come back to this by the end of the talk. I would like to start by talking about the DNA structure. Watson and Crick published this structure in 1953, and thanks to Rosalind Franklin's X-ray diffraction images, they concluded that the DNA molecule is a right-handed helix formed by tuple nucleotide chains. The DNA molecule is almost 2 meters long, and the nucleus of the cell ranges from 5 to 20 micrometers diameter. So to fit in, the DNA has to be packed very, very tightly. To be packed, the DNA is bound to histones, and this structure is called chromatin. The basic unit of the chromatin is the nucleosome. And, well, the canonical nucleosome is a very well characterized molecule. It is formed by 146 base pairs of DNA that wrap in a left-handed manner around an octamer of histones. The packaging in left-handed nucleosomes not only makes the fiber to fit in the nucleus, but also creates a reservoir of negative helical tension in the chromatin molecule. So this means that when the histones are removed from the chromatin, the DNA keeps this negative supercoiling to help the bases of the DNA to come apart from each other. So the enzymes related to transcription or DNA replication can easily access to the DNA sequence. Well, until a few years ago, it was thought that the left-handed nucleosome was the only, possible nucleosome structure. But different studies have shown that this is not true. We have histone variants, histone modifications, and different DNA sequences that result in different nucleosome structures. These nucleosome structures cause changes in the chromatin architecture, and these have an impact on all the chromosomal processes. The most extreme case of a special nucleosome would be the centromeric one. The centromere is a critical point for proper separation of sister chromatids, and the centromeric nucleosome is formed by 4 histones instead of the 8 of the canonical nucleosome by a variant of histone H3 and a very specific DNA sequence. At this moment, it is a heated debate as to whether it is right or left-handed. During my thesis, I have studied the topology of the centromeric nucleosome, and we have seen that it is a right-handed nucleosome. And, well, this broke the rule, and now it would be very important to know why there is a different wrap of the DNA around the nucleosome. So we think that there should be more different nucleosomes in the genome, so now we are studying the promoter regions. The promoter is the region just at the beginning of every gene, and is the binding site for the RNA polymerase. Usually, it is composed by 3 or 4 nucleosomes, and this nucleosome has also histone variants and a lot of histone modifications. So we hope that we can find there also singular nucleosomes. And now, just the answers to the questions that I posted at the beginning. What is a nucleosome? A nucleosome is a section of DNA that is wrapped around a core of histone. And what is the main difference between a canonical nucleosome and the centromeric nucleosome? It would be the wrapping of the DNA. So thank you very much.